we've tried to X, so you can put the X on the left side.
Okay, so I'll try and get it looking like this equation here. So if you subtract X from both sides, here's what it'll look like now. We get the, and we'll write it in the order X, Y. So negative X is what we have, plus Y equals 0.6. All right, so that looks good. It's all lined up and stuff. So what do you think now? Trying to get the X's or Y's to cancel out, right?
Oh, well, I mean, you can always just multiply by 5.
Okay, multiply the bottom equation by 5. So we'll multiply the left side by 5, right side by 5. Okay, here's the top equation, 5x minus 5y equals negative 3. 5 times negative x is negative 5x. 5 times y is positive 5y. I'm sure there's a way for you to walk. 5 times 0.6. We have together the 5x minus 5x is 0, and negative 5y plus 5y is 0. Okay. So that's like new to this section, new to 7.5. Sometimes the left side of the equation will completely get wiped out. And it doesn't mean you did anything wrong. There's no better way to solve it so that you get the right solution. This is just what happens. And what we get over here is very important. What do we get on this side? So whether we get 0 or we get something else, it's important. It's key to what we say is the answer, what we say the solution is. Because we get something that's true, like all the variables get canceled out, but what is left is something that's true. 0 does equal 0. Since it's true, we can say that there are infinitely many solutions. Or you can just say infinite solutions. That means is that because these two equations turn out to be exactly the same as each other, all the solutions for one are the same as the solutions for the other. Solve this equation. If you find a solution for this equation, it's going to be a solution for that equation. Okay. So there's not one solution. There's not like 6, 8, or 5, 3, or some one answer, one solution for this system. There's infinitely many. If we were to instead get 0 equals anything with 0, 0 equals 1, 0 equals negative 3, 0 equals 3/4, then that means that there's no way that these two equations will ever both be equal with the same x and y. There are no solutions. So since 0 equals 0, that's true, we get infinite solutions. If we were, for example, to get 0 equals 2, which is false, we say there's no solutions. Means that the x's and y's are exactly the same in this situation, but you're trying to get two different answers. And you can see from this equation, if 5x minus 5y equals negative 3, then of course, if everything's opposite, negative 5x plus 5y, positive 3. It's just the same equation.
So y is equal to?
What's that?
Y is equal to. It doesn't say.
Oh, no, that was just an example I made up that, yeah. I made up the example. Okay, so that was 18, and now 22. To get like it, get it to look like it normally does. There's a little bit of work to do.
Subtract
subtract 8y, so now we have the x and y parts on the same side. So if I were to rewrite this, so we have the x first, so we have 5x plus 4y equals 15. And we write this as x minus 8y, so just subtract 8y from both sides, equals 3. Now it looks the same, so now we can work with that. What's that? What do you mean by negative 5? What do you mean by negative 5?
Times 1.
Times negative
5.
Or you can substitute. Oh, you said earlier.
We could have used substitution instead. Plug 8y plus 3 in for x. Okay. We can do that real quick after we get this done. So we have 5x plus 4y. It's just the top equation being rewritten. Now, negative 5 times x, negative 5x, and these are going to cancel out. So negative 5 times negative 8y is a positive 40y. Negative 5 times 3 is negative 15. 5x minus 5x is 0. 4y plus 40y is 44y. Well, 15 minus 15 is 0. So if we divide by 44, y is 0.
Wouldn't that be just a no solution?
Yeah.
No, it's not 0 equals 0. It's saying like the number that works for y is the number 0.
Oh, okay.
So y is 0, and that means that x is something. Some number x goes along with that number 0. We can go back to this one since it's already got x by itself. I'm just going to plug in 0 for y, which would be really easy to do, right? 8 times 0 is 0.
3.
So x is 3. We find the exact same solution if we instead use substitution. So I'll put this stuff here in for x in this equation, 4y plus 5 times 8y plus 3 equals 15. Distributing the 5, we get 4y plus
40y.
Plus 40y. 15 equals 15.
Yeah.
We'll subtract 15 from both sides. 44y equals 0. Plug it in and find, again, x is 3. Which is what I said would happen. I said we'll get the same solution if we use substitution, if we use elimination. If we were to graph them, we would find that they intersect at 3, 0.
Yeah.
And last was 36.
36. Oh.
Or am I wrong?
No, you're right.
Okay. I've been confused. 2. One admission to a roller skating rink costs X dollars. So X is the price of admission. And renting a pair of skates costs Y dollars. You're going to pay some amount to get in. We don't know how much that is yet. We're going to pay a certain amount to rent skates. We don't know how much that is yet. But what I assume they're going to do is they're going to tell us a couple of examples. This person did this, and it cost them this much. This is the person did this other thing, and it cost them that much. A group pays a total of $243. Okay, so this is like scenario A. They tell us anything else. They have 36 people come, so they're going to pay the 36 people to get in. That's admission. And 21 skate rentals. How come only 21 skate rentals?
Are people already have skates?
Yeah, so some of the people who showed up are super cool, and they already have their roller skates.
I know. They do have skates.
So another group, it's called like group B. They show up, they spend a total of
$81.
$81, just a good memory.
Yeah.
For 12 people to come in and 7 skate rentals. So they have 2 different groups doing 2 different things, getting 2 different totals. we should be able to, unless it's this one particular scenario, should be able to figure out how much skate rentals cost and how much admission it is. So we gotta write two equations to start with.
Okay, well,
shall
can
we?
I help you with that?
Yes, you can.
Alright, so 243 equals 36x and plus 21y.
That makes sense, because this is their total cost. To get the total cost, you gotta add up two things. How much did they pay to get in, and how much did they pay in skate rentals? Well, 36 people came in, times x is the cost of admission. 21 people rented skates, and y is the cost of skate rentals. So if we add those two together, we should get the total cost, and the total cost is 243. Second equation, then it'll be really similar, because they did a really similar thing, right? $81 is the sum of admission and skate rentals. The admission is 12 people times x dollars per admission plus the skate rentals, that's 7 people times the cost of renting skates.
I noticed something right away when I wrote these two down.
What did you notice?
I noticed that everything at the top equation is divisible by 3, so I divided it by 3.
So you notice that the second equation, you can get the second equation by dividing everything in the first equation by 3.
I didn't say that, but I was going to let that happen.
You were going to let that happen?
When you divide it by 3.
Okay, what did you notice? Like,
so
did you notice this?
No.
You can divide this by 3 and get 7? That's what you noticed.
Well, I noticed that and also 36, but I wasn't sure on the 243.
I wasn't sure about that one.
So I just took everything and divided by 3.
And just so happens that
it's the same equation.
Okay. So what they did, they tried to help us out and give us two different groups doing two different things so that we could use them to figure out how much it must cost to get in and how much it must cost to rent skates. The only thing is, they basically took this one scenario and then like three of those same groups show up, and of course they're gonna spend 3 times as much. You could have told me that without ever knowing that. If 12 people show up and 7 people rent skates, and it costs $81. If 3 times as many people show up and 3 times as many people rent skates, it should cost 3 times as much.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I don't even know how much it costs to get in or how much it costs to rent skates to tell you that. What I need is a different kind of combination of people that's not a multiple of, you know, not the same multiple of 12 as it is 7. I need to, like, 36 people showing up and 20 skate rentals. I need something like that. Something that's not just a multiple of the other group. So if we do divide both sides by 3, and we trust Shelby, which we'll trust Shelby, we'll get, it turns out, the exact same equation. Divide this by 3, you get 81. Divide this by 3, you get 12x. Divide this by 3, you get 7y. And then when I try to maybe make everything negative, multiply both sides by a negative 1, I just get
infinite solutions.
0 equals 0.
It's
really
just the same line.
Information.
Yeah, it's just the same line. You know it's going to be this 0 equals 0.
Yeah.
And so you can't find the information of anything costly because it's just the same thing we're thinking.
Exactly. That's exactly what happened. We cannot figure out how much this stuff costs because they just told you basically the same information twice.
Yeah.
They just told you the original, like, this information times 3. But if these numbers, if you couldn't get these numbers by just multiplying these by the same number, then that would have helped. So in trying to figure out how much everything costs, we'll never know unless they tell us something else, some other piece of information that's different from this and that. So no solution. We'll never figure it out from what we have.
No.
Oh, sorry.
Infinite
solutions, not no solutions. But we'll never figure out how much it costs to get in and how much skate rentals cost. Let's see. Haley, do you want to see another one or two?
No, that's okay.
You think it helped?
Yeah.
Okay. So, I mean, we have three good examples here. Except we didn't get any no solution, but we got infinite solutions twice.
No solution is just when B doesn't equal up. It's supposed to be even on both sides, but it's not.
Let me just manufacture that situation, like, 2x plus 4y equals 8, and 6x plus 12y equals 10. Okay. So we're gonna come up with those solutions here. If I try and get like these x's to cancel out, maybe I'll multiply both sides by negative 3. Right. So that'll give me, in the top equation, it'll give me a negative 6x, a negative 12y, and a negative 24. And the second equation is 6x plus 12y equals 10. When I add the left side together, negative 6x plus 6x is 0. That's what I wanted to have happen, but then the y's also happen to cancel each other out, so we get 0y. So we have 0 on this side.
The
other side.
Out.
We get negative 14. Okay? If you want to know if it's infinite solutions or no solutions, you just have to ask yourself, is that true, or is it not true? And what's the answer? Is it true or no? That last line that I've written on the board, is it true or not true? Well, it's just, it's an equation. It's just a number on either side of the equation.
That's a no solution.
Yeah. If I told you that 0 equals negative 14, would you believe that? 0 equals negative 14, then all of math would be doomed.
Yay!
It just be 0.
It would be even more difficult than you think it is right
Let's
now.
Let's kill math.
Okay. If 0 equals negative 14, then every number would equal every other number.
Absolutely.
And that would be
math.
Bad news. We don't want that.
Can you imagine if animals equal math?
Yes.
That would
be like slop sack.
Actually,
so,
you think that animals will emit math, and you're going to go, dude, that's the best.
So since this is a false statement, we have no solution. And again, that's because, I mean, take a look at what we have here. We have 6x plus 12y equals 10. If I multiply both sides of this equation by a negative 1, I'll get 6x plus 12y equals 24. How could 6x plus 12y equal 10? And 6x plus 12y also equal 24 at the same time.
I don't know, it can't.
It can't. The same x and y can't go into both of those equations. It won't work. Either I'm going to get an x and y that it comes out to equal 10, or I'm going to get an x and y that comes out to equal 24, but I can't get an x and y to go together to make 10, and then like I do the work over again and come up with 24 as well. Okay? So, ain't going to happen.